Well, someone with first-hand experience of both the American and Australian missions in Afghanistan is Canberra photojournalist Gary Ramage. A former member of the armed services himself, his day job is for News Limited, covering the political fray, mostly at Parliament House. But he has a passion for documenting the war. He's recently back from a two-month trip, travelling with both US and Australian forces. His photos and his moving footage give an extraordinary perspective on the mission.
What I try and do, I try and embed with the soldiers. I try and tell the soldiers' story because that's my focus. That's what I'm very interested in trying to do. You know, I believe that the Australian public should know what our diggers are doing in Afghanistan. I do spend time with the Americans as well, and that's just to give me a different aspect on, you know, how the Americans do things compared to how the Australians do things. The country varies from desolate, barren land sets like a scene from Star Wars. It's like, it's biblical, it's unbelievable. And all of a sudden these grain oases will just pop up from nowhere. You know, it's so lush and so full of green vegetation. And it's just one extreme to the other. It's quite amazing. You know, you walk into this green zone, you can't see that far in front of you from all the vegetation. And once you get to the other end, you're out in the middle of the desert again. It's unbelievable. The hours you work are very sort of long and quite intense because you're trying to fit in with the soldiers that you're working with, and those boys are working between 18 and 20 hour days. They don't get much sleep, they don't get much rest. You know, and when they do get rest, they're either preparing for the next mission or they're cleaning weapons or cleaning equipment or trying to get some sleep. So it is, it's a difficult place and a difficult environment to work in. Well, you need good stamina to maintain it. Because you can be up at 5 or 4 o'clock in the morning and you won't stop again till midnight sometimes. But mentally, it is a bit of a hard slog, mate, because there's all these emotional stuff running through you as well, you know.
Tracer! Down!
I turn myself off, especially when there's a lot of bad stuff going on. For me, anyway, for me to function, I need to tune out. You know, you can't photograph death and disaster and get emotionally attached to it. And that sounds a bit robotic, I know, but that's the only way I can function in some of these places. I don't try to get emotionally attached to the people I'm out there with. That would just be, I think, disastrous for me as a working photographer. It's never good when people die. I don't like photographing it, but it's unfortunately part of the job. And you know, you have to be able to deal with that mentally so you can actually go on and actually do the job for the next day and the day after and the day after that. Probably some of the worst stuff I've done was last year working with the American dust-off crews, where we'd fly in, or they would fly in, I was a passenger with them, into a contact zone where there was still engagements going on, and they'd you know, land in what they call a hot LZ. So there'd be rounds flying everywhere, these guys land in, the two medics, or the medic will run out of the helicopter, he'll run into the fire to rescue, you know, an injured Marine or an injured soldier. Bringing those guys back to the helicopter and watching the medics actually trying to perform first aid, CPR, save their lives. It's pretty harrowing stuff. I had three guys die me in one day in the back of a Black Hawk helicopter over a period of hours. And, you know, all the heartstrings, even now I'm getting goosebumps, all the heartstrings pull at you going, you know, don't take that picture. But I did. But I tried to do it in such a way where I couldn't identify the Marines, and that was purely out of respect for them. You know, nobody wants to see sort of, whether it's Taliban or what, no one wants to see dead bodies, you know, bleeding on the floor. I mean, I don't speak the language, and there's a lot of different sort of dialects of the language, but from my time there and people I've tried to speak to and through interpreters and everything else, I think they just want the country back. They just want to get on with life. They want the soldiers out of there. Whether that's going to do them any good or not, I don't know, but that's more or less what they keep telling us, is that they just want to get on with their life, they want to farm, and they just want to live life. There isn't a soldier or a digger I've met that didn't know why they were there. They're all volunteers, you know. Nobody asked to go to war. Like, we don't want a war, but, you know, if the government of the day decides that that's what the army has to do, then that's what the soldiers will do. I don't sort of classify myself as a war photographer, and that's all I do. You know, I'm a news photographer. I photograph news events. That's what I'm about. Coming back from Afghanistan to Canberra, there's no real big shift in how I approach my craft. You know, there's a job to do, and I'll go and do that job. I'm just lucky that I get to take pictures every day, mate. You know, I don't think I've won too many friends up there in the sort of bureaucratic area in Parliament House by pushing the envelope. But that's what I do overseas. You know, I push the envelope to get the pictures that I think the public has a right to know. And the way we view it is, at the end of the day, we're there to photograph the politicians for the Australian people, so the Australian public know what it is our politicians are up to. And that, you know, that's the motivation behind us getting the pictures. I have a line in the sand I've drawn. I don't get personally attached to the politicians. I know there are a lot of photographers that do and befriend politicians and however you want to try and get stuff, but... And I think it's pretty obvious the way I work is that everyone knows where my boundaries are. I don't have this one burning image to try and capture out of Parliament. There's nothing that sort of springs to mind for me. I mean, obviously, you know, the stuff I've done in Afghanistan, I don't think I can top that. From a photographic perspective, there's no way I could top that stuff, especially from last year with Dust Off. You know, you just can't capture that type of emotion.
Adam Shirley produced that story.